Well, I have too much to say, and since we only get 3 minutes, I wrote a poem.
Thank you.
I'm glad you're my godmother, someone who has held my hand through the challenging obstacles of my life, a friend that I should need, who is always loved and understands. I just want to say thank you, as you really are the best. With you beside me through my life,
yes.
I know that I've been blessed.
This time, Sonny Kathy and Latoya Logan. What a song. After this, we're going to have Sister Sandra Jordan.
Okay.
I'm going to go ahead and sign it because she came along. I did not want to give anything, so I just got a couple things down. And I just kind of like, what do you say to somebody has made such a huge impact in your life? And the best I can come up with is thank you. And there's a few things I just want to thank you for. Thank you for praying for me and with me, literally kneeling down right here on the benches, praying with me, encouraging me, loving me, correcting me, directing me. Thank you for being there when my child was diagnosed with autism, letting me know everything was going to be all right. And how everybody said their child's her favorite. Thank you for, she should take Javon over here out of daycare and bring him and let him play on the drums, which is probably a no-no. But she let him do it because she knew he liked music and that was just his way of expression at the time. And I just want to thank you for spending that extra time, that quality time with him. And thank you for blessing me with a job. Thank you for helping me as a young mother that could barely pay child care when things were tight. Thank you for being an example, a living example of a virtuous woman. Showing me what it means to not get hung up in material things and just to be, present yourself acceptable and dignified before people. And thank God, thank you for telling me that God delights in me.
Yeah.
When we were praying down there, that's one thing that stuck with me throughout the years, is when you said, Latoya, God delights in me. Did you know that? And that stuck with me a long time.
Yeah.
And when I'm down and that comes up, it helps lift me back up. Thank you for the oil, the anointing on your life to keep that flow over to all of us. And I just want to say, I had decided when I found out I was pregnant that my child would not be in daycare. Both my children went to New Orleans. I had decided that I was going to find someone who would watch my children in their home, and that was just what I was going to do. And then I met Mrs. Snowy. And I saw the vision, and her vision was to love every woman.
Thank you,
Father. And to serve every woman.
Yes.
And I wanted my children to see that vision. I wanted that to be embedded in them. And so they came here. Not only did she do that, but she loved all of our babies. Every single one of our children felt like they were the most special person in the world. Thank you. She modeled praise and worship. There was a time when my son Mike went to
church with Latoya, didn't know anyone at the church except for Latoya. And they asked, does anybody want to lead a song? Bless probably six. Who raises his hand? And he gets up, takes the microphone, and leaves this little white line. He did not get that from me because I don't like talking in front of him. Miss Evelyn, thank you again. You provide stability and structure for our babies. You show compassion not only to our babies, but to the parents.
Yes.
Thank you,
Father. I'm one of those guilty parents who came in on two meals after hours every day. And this time we just smiled and loved on me in a way. Thank you. You pray for our babies.
Yes.
Not only did you pray for our babies, but you pray for us parents.
Yes.
Thank you, Ms. Nellie. Alexa, she in school had a talk with some of her friends about daycare. And she found out that not everybody gets anointed with no oil. So she came home asking me questions. Thank you, Ms. Last but not least, you have been an example to the children and the parents of how to live a godly life.
Yes.
And again, I have to say, thank you.
Y'all can keep coming up and saying she was y'all's child's favorite. I already told y'all the secret children were the favorites. Accept it. And put some respect on it. Sister Sandra Jordan, after which you gotta have Sister Gilmore.
Amen.
Yes, Brother Sandy, you can come to me. We will let you speak.
First of all, we work as a team and we know that child that Sister Carol was talking about.
I just
saw it. He passed out at the daycare. And thank you, Miss Noni, for praying for him.
Yes.
And you're just an amazing woman. And I don't do a lot of talking, but I just know in my heart, we are mothers. And we know when we should pray. And I just thank you so much because I'm like the gentleman said, when you bring your child to daycare, if you have somebody you can trust and feel comfortable with and pray for your child, I'm all right. So thank you, Ms. Norman. And I love you.
Amen.
She's a brand new writer. She's a good worker with you. Ms. Norman, we just thank you so much. And all you've done. All the blessings you've given to our family and everyone who worked at the daycare. That little boy is taller than I am. And he still comes to the daycare and works. And volunteers to come. That's how much the God is good. And we're so grateful.
Thank you, God.
And we're thankful. Sister Holman, we know what it is. God has been so good to us.
Thank you, Father.
And we just want to thank you. And we just hope every day is a blessing. I'm going to try to be a woman right now. I'm going to sit there. Amen.
Amen.
God is truly good. Amen.
Yes.
Until Melody made the man a pudding. Now he smiled all the time, and when Melody had the man a pudding, there was a different smile about it. But I couldn't even be jealous because he loved Melody's banana pudding.
To God be the glory.
so delighted to be here. Thank you, Ms. Collins, for calling me, sharing this great celebration. I have to say Sister McCullough, like you. I just always have to say Sister McCullough. We were directors of daycare centers out of IBH. She was here. You know, it's just a blessing when you can support and help one another. Yeah. It wasn't any like, you know, how many kids you got and all this kind of, we just supported and helped one another. And we're not going to think about all those state reports that we wanted to throw out the door sometimes. All those USDA programs, nobody really knows what a director goes through and operating their facilities. And we make it all, you know, and we was all, we make it look good, just call it, do it, they make it, but you have a lot of hats that you wear as a daycare director. And I just want to say to you, Susan McCullough, you was one of the best daycare directors in Maryland.
Take care of her family, how
do nice things for her family.
Thank you, Lord.
This is things that I think in her. I think about all the things that she has done down through the years, how she nurtured the parents, nurtured the children, how she took a whole lot of stuff that people don't even know about. God knows. You know, but God is going to have the last say, Lord.
Yes.
Lord. Yes. That's right. I don't have anything to say about this situation. I thank God for how he has kept this
voice.
Yes. He included me. You know, everybody I'm talking about, different loves and how she did the children, the parents. But I can go back and remember how she teach. She's a great teacher. I think about the time that Jesus was teaching the people and how she's going to come in here and start teaching everybody's mouth like God because they say, I do not think the thing that she said, you know, so much wisdom, so much knowledge
that,
you know, nobody don't know about, you know, a lot of people don't know about her teaching, but I always remember, I can tell anybody that she was a great teacher. Her mother was a great teacher.
Yeah.
You know, I go back and think about the times that she was here and how she would bring things out, how she would lock the trouble, see blood coming down. You know, she was a great teacher. And that stone came home. That mantle fell into the
cover.
And I thank God for what he gave her, that wisdom, that understanding, that knowledge, that you can come to her in any situation and she can give you an answer for it. I thank God because when I was in North Carolina teaching my dad how I was going through some things, and I called up because you know you need to go to somebody got some wisdom. You don't go to a person that's not a faith person, not a faithful enemy, and get knowledge from. You need to go to somebody that got some wisdom and understanding. So I would call her up. Little chat nobody knew about when we had him and how she would tell me, instruct me, and let me know what I need to do. And I appreciate that so much. So I'm telling you, I love you then and I love you now. And ain't nobody do me like Jesus. I know that you love him because you love the children, you love the parents, you get a whole lot of things behind the scenes that nobody knows. So I'm saying today, God bless you. And you see many more things to come.
Amen. I never done that because I had to stay home with my kids until they were able to talk and walk.
I just